Ihumātao is a sacred piece of Māori land taken by the Crown in 1865 and eventually sold to Fletcher Building, which wants to put almost 500 houses on it. Now, activists, of course, as we've seen in the news, they aren't having a bar of it, among them Pania Newton, who has led the fight to save this taonga. She is with us live. Morena.
Morena.
Pania, tell us what's happened overnight.
So overnight, there have been hundreds of kaitiaki, we would say, arrived to the whenua to stand in solidarity with our whānau and our marae to protect our wāhi tapu and this rare cultural heritage landscape.
And this morning?
This morning we can expect that there's going to be more buses arriving from Poneke and the Hokianga and Taranaki as well. But this morning I was running a little bit late because police were beginning to advance on the tent area where there are kaitiaki and families currently staying in defence of the whenua.
And what are your concerns around that?
My major concern at the moment is a possible arrest. We've seen over the last couple of days those are likely to happen during dusk and dawn, which takes my mind back to the dawn raids. And I think of our Pasifika whānau and Māori who lived through that. My concern are with the families and the tamariki and our own whānau and our marae and the legacy that might be left for our papakāinga.
You got quite emotional earlier when you saw some of the pictures that we've been running. You haven't seen a lot of that because you've been caught in the middle of it. This is really personal for you, isn't it?
Absolutely. This is my tūranga waiwai. And in Pākehā terms, you would describe that as the place where you feel your greatest sense of belonging and place. This is where I've grown up. This is where I envision my mokopuna and my children's placenta, their whenua, will go if I have children in the future.
One of the local iwi, Te Kawarau Amaki, they are, I guess, trying to discredit you, really. They've made some pretty bold statements. They've said you are not mana whenua, that you're an outsider, that you're basically a troublemaker who's come in here and that you do not represent the people of the land. What do you say to that?
Yeah, I've been described as a rāwaho, a foreigner. And it's really sad that you would see these elders or kaumātua abusing their privilege. You know, my aroha goes to them, but my kaumātua and our kuia from our papakāinga and our marae, they are supporting us and they've guided us through this over the past 4.5 years. They haven't been aiding and abetting our Fletchers as other iwi may have been, but my guidance comes from my kaumātua and my kuia who are standing on the front lines with us to defend our taonga and our wāhi tapu.
So your line on this is that there are actually multiple iwi involved here. There are multiple iwi that are claiming a stake in this land. Not all of them have been involved in that consultation process. Is that right?
Absolutely. There are many hapu affiliated to our marae and none of them have been consulted about whether or not this development should go ahead.
Fletcher is saying, look, this is a done deal, we've gone through the right processes, we've followed the law, surely they've ticked all the boxes.
Oh, well, we know, and history tells us, that the law is against us. We look at the Heritage Places Act, and it's discriminatory towards Māori-built heritage and our Māori sites of significance, you know, wāhi tapu.
Yeah.
And so it's almost like in the back of our minds we've known that we would inevitably come to something like this, even though we've worked really hard over the past 5 years to call on the government and Auckland Council to intervene and prevent a confrontation so that we don't repeat the mistakes of the past.
Well, the government is running a mile from this. They say this is not our responsibility. We don't want to intervene. We don't want to go over the heads of the local iwi or that particular iwi. What is it that you actually want from the government, especially given that this is private land, this is not public or Crown land?
I want the government to turn their heads and their hearts to our marae, the hub of our papakāinga and our community. And they have strongly opposed over all these years against this development. They need to listen to our marae, who represents the many other hapu who are affiliated to this whenua. They are asking the government to intervene, prevent the confrontation and return the whenua back to mana whenua whom the land was stolen
from. But the government may well say, look, well, Māori are divided on this. You know, this has basically got ugly and we're seeing Māori pitted against Māori. How can we actually bring everyone around the table and get a solution? And are you actually willing to compromise, or do you want no development and that's it?
our stance has always been to protect and preserve this whenua as a cultural heritage landscape, as wahi tapu, and that was the intention that the Manukau City Council had in 2007.
Will you reach a compromise? Negotiate?
Our stance has always been not to compromise. Ihumātao has compromised a lot, and enough for the greater good of Auckland since 1863.
We've got to go, just quickly. This is symbolic, isn't it? This is not just about this particular piece of land, and it seems like a lot of people are waking up to our history of land confiscation.
Absolutely. We look over to Hawaii, and we see our relations at defending Mauna Kea. We think about Indigenous rights, Māori rights. We think about environmental degradation and the climate crises that we are fighting. This is a fight for feminism. It's against capitalism, and it's to uphold tino rangatiratanga and to uphold Indigenous rights, because we know it's the Indigenous people who we look to save the world.
All right, Pania, we really appreciate you coming all the way into our studio this morning. We'll wait and see what the developments are today. I know you've got your gumboots on. All the best for how things play out today.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Thank you.